Good evening and welcome to Lillis Court at Loras College for what should be a very exciting men's volleyball match between the Rockford University Regents and your Loras College Duhawks. We are currently meeting tonight's starting lineups and we will have this match away very shortly. Welcome back after starting lineups. Teams are in their little huddles right before, and we will have first serve here very shortly. Again, welcome to Loras College men's volleyball. Should be a very exciting game tonight. Loras just recently ranked in the national rankings for the first time in program history at number 15. Let's see how great we really are. Couple key players to look for here on that Duhawks team. Number 23, Dorian Fiorenza, leading the team in kills with 139 in his career. He's fifth in kills in his career as a junior. Definitely someone to look out for, as well as number 20, Pat Mahoney. He is the blocks leader for this Duhawks team and was actually last year the first All-American in this program's history. So watch out for those two on that Duhawks side. Regents will have the first serve of the game. Waiting for officials, everything. Jose Padron is serve for the Regents, and we are off. Attempt is good. Killed there by Dwar. Good start for the Duhawks. 1-0 already. Fiorenza to go back for the serve. Fiorenza serve over. Up to Dixon. Dorian, good dig. Horn sets up Maya. Dig by the Regents. Up close to the net. Alder's little tip over. Kessel up to Ziegenhorn. Ziegenhorn's attempt just long and out of bounds. Regents will have the serve. Michael Moss back to serve for the Regents. His jump serve over. Fiorenza receives it. Horn up to Mayotte. Nice little tip. Alder's up to Moss. Moss's attempt dug by Kessel. Horn up to Ziegenhorn. Ziegenhorn is blocked, but it goes out of bounds. Point for the Duhawks. Dwar back to serve for the Duhawks. His serve up and over. Padron receives it. Tip by Mayotte. Good heads up there from Corey Maya up front. Duhawks up 3-1 early in the first set. Dwar serve up and over. Alvers. Fiorenza up to Maya. His kill. Good kill there for Maya. He's starting early. That's definitely someone you want for Duhawks to get started early with 86 kills on the season. Look out for him as well on that outside. Very deadly hitter, a lot of power behind those attempts. block from Pat Mahoney. Duhawks up 6-1 now. 5-1. Dwar served just a bit long. Point goes towards the Regents. Albers serve up and over. Oh, ace from Albers. Whew. Great ace there from Albers. Way to get started for him. As I said earlier, Duhawks coming in as number 15 nationally. They're coming into this game with a 12-1 record and a 3-0 record in their conference play. As for the Regents, Pat Mahoney's kill is good. Duhawks up 6-3 now. As for the Regents, they're coming into this match at 2-13 and 0-4 in match play. Regents are coming off of a loss against St. Norbert. They lost that match 3-0, whereas the Duhawks coming off of a very, very solid win, a 3-0 win against Augustana. Pat Mahoney up to Kesser, Mayotte. Padron tip. Nice little tap there from Padron to get them a point. 6-4 Duhawks. Regents will have the serve. Isaiah Dixon back to serve for the Regents. Jump serve over. Fiorenza receives it. Horn up to Fiorenza. Whew! Man, that was a lot of power behind that kill there from Fiorenza. Expect a lot of those powerful, powerful kills from number 23. Man, he can get up. Maya back to serve for the Duhawks. Jump serve up over. Received by Magdadaro. Maya to Horn. Horn to Maya. Maya from back. Oh, man. I'm not entirely sure what just happened there at the Regents. A little misread. Almost didn't want to go for a double hit. His team didn't realize it. Maya still back to serve for the Duhawks. Serve, drop down, up to Padron. Padron's tip right into the net. Duhawks now up 9-4 over the Regents here in the first set. Yeah, jump serve up over. Oh, right back over the net for Duhawks. Horn up to Fiorenza, and his kill is good. 10-4 Duhawks. And it's going to be a timeout called by the Regents. Duhawks up 10-4 at the timeout. Duhawks getting the wheels rolling here very early in this match. It's going to be a they're going to have a lot of success this game if they can get Fiorenza hot and a lot of kills here in this game. He's already at 2 with Maya at 3. Getting those two. Get those two hot early, and they will be in a great path to victory here tonight over the Regents. Looking at a couple stats for Loris coming into this game in conference play. Loris leads conference in kills with 548. A lot of those, like I said earlier, coming from Dorian Fiorenza, along with Pat Mahoney at 83, Andres Martinez 52, and Corey Mayotte at 86. Very, very good team up close to the net and going for those kills and attempts. And a lot of power behind all of those kills. Timeout has ended. Mayo back to serve for the Duhawks. His serve up and into the net. Point Regents. Regents have Karpenko back to serve for them. His serve up. Over received by Kessel. Fiorenza. Attempt just out of bounds. Point will go to the Regents. Karpenko still back to serve. Karpenko jump serve into the net. Point Duhawks.
Point Duhawks.
All-American Pat Mahoney back to serve for the Duhawks. Attempt by the Regents is good. Killed by number 10, Connor McNear. That's his first of the night. Won't be surprised if we see a lot more of those coming from McNear tonight. At 64 kills on the season, now 65. In their last game against St. Norbert, McNear had 5 kills to go along with Jose Padron's 10. Look out for Padron on that outside as well, as he's got 107 kills on the season. Trey Perez back to serve for the Regents. The serve into the net. Duhawks now up 12-8 here in this first set. Joe Horn back to serve for the Duhawks. Unbelievable setter that the Duhawks have here in Joe Horn. He's currently the assist leader and ace leader. This serve up over, received by the Regents. Alvers Tomas just a little missed set there from Albers. Moss just kind of timed it poorly. Unfortunate event there for the Regents. Horn still back to serve. Horn served right into the net. Back to Horn on this season. I said he's the assist leader. He's got coming into this game, he had 373 assists. Unreal numbers from that man, Joe Horn. Just an unbelievable setter and someone that served there from Padron. Good. Nice little ace from Padron. Joe Horn being a senior, he's a junior, so they're going to have him back next year, and that's definitely a huge benefit for the Duhawks to bring him back, as a great setter he is. Padron served into the net. Fiorenza back to serve for the Duhawks. Oh, good serve there from Fiorenza. Up to Horn. Horn to Dwar. Just out of bounds from Dwar. 14-10 Duhawks here late in the first set. Michael Moss back to serve for the Regents. Jump serve over. Fiorenza receives it. Horn up to Mayotte. Attempt. Dixon tip blocked by Duhawks, but out of bounds. Point will go to the Regents. Up to Dwar. Dwar's attempt good, just off the hands of the Regents at the net, and that flies out of bounds. Point goes to the Duhawks. Dwar now back to serve after his kill. Padron receives. Albers up to Dixon. Dixon's kill receive from Fiorenza. Ziegenhorn. Little miss hit there. Albers. Fiorenza just couldn't get that. Could not get the dig off of Albers. Albers kill there. Albers will now go back to serve for the Regents. Albers serves into the net. Checking into the game for the Duhawks, number 22, David Beach, as he will go back to serve. Checking out would be Tucker Ziegenhorn. Beach serve up and over. Dixon receives. Horn up to Mahoney. Mahoney's kill. And there was no stop kill there from Pat Mahoney. I see why he was an All-American last year. Beach at service again. Serve. Oh, just into the net. Point goes to the Regents. Back serve for the Regents will be number three, Isaiah Dixon. His serve just left and out of bounds. As for the Regents, I mentioned earlier, 2-13, 0-4, not the record I'm sure they were hoping for, but when you look at their roster, it's a lot. They are a very young team. No seniors on the roster. And so you gotta believe that in the next few years, this Regents team will have a lot of success, as they will all have a very good amount of experience. Rally here in the match. And the block by Joe Horn. Whew. Oh, yeah. What a way to end a nice little volley. Have Joe Horn get up there and just put it right back down on the Regents side. Maya to serve. Back to the region. So, I mean, being super young, couple juniors, obviously they have the experience, but a lot of just freshmen and sophomores. So I wouldn't be surprised if in the next few years this team has built up and they have a much better record than what we're seeing right now, and wouldn't be surprised if we hear their name a little bit more in the coming years. Firenze's attempt, luck the net, Moss. Mahoney up to Horn. Horn, nice little tip. Good little tip there from Joe Horn. Good IQ play there from Horn to see that there's no one there in that middle of the region side. Just put it right in the spot that no one was there. Mahoney back to serve for the Duhawks. Blocked by Dwar and Fiorenza on that left side. The attempt was coming from Connor McNear. Dorian Fiorenza and Michael Dwar said, not today, sir.
Yeah, okay, the bench is always doing something like
this. Mahoney back to serve. Serve over. Moss up to Padron. Padron's attempt just long and out of bounds.
Point to us.
Regents are looking to. Thought maybe the Duhawks had tipped it, but the ref is saying just sailed out of bounds. Mahoney serve up and over. Padron receives it. Dwar just slams it right back down onto the Regents' house. After a missed return from Padron, sets up Dwar right there in the middle. Mahoney serve up and just long from Pat Mahoney. Point Regents. Duhawks up 23-16 here in the later stages of the first set. Checking into the game for the Regents and going back for service, number 14, Trey Perez. And for number 10, Connor McNear. Perez serve, long and out of bounds. Point Duhawks, 24-16. Checking into the game, and making his first appearance, number 13, Keegan Godwin, and checking as well, number 4, Tucker Ziegenhorn. Keegan will check in and go right back to service. Offers up to Padron, his tip. Feel good. Yeah, there from Padron. Point goes to the Regents. Now after his kill, Padron will go back to serve. Iote receives a serve. Fiorenza. Oh, man. There was a lot of steam from that kill from Dorian Fiorenza, and that will put the DuHawks up 25-17 and give them the first set, putting them one set to none over the Regents. 3 minutes on the clock, and we'll be back for the second set. A couple stats here. Corey Mayo, Michael Zwar, and Patrick Mahoney, and Dorian Fiorenza leading the team in kills so far for the DuHawks. They have a total of 13 kills to the Regents' 5. Looking a little bit into the DuHawks this season. Coming into tonight's game, they were first in their league with 92 blocks, averaging about two a set. Pretty, very solid numbers there from the DuHawks, as blocks aren't that easy to get all the time. As well as being taken in third in the league with 81 aces. Again, very solid numbers from the DuHawks. And 481 digs, being second in the CCIW with 10.93 digs a set. I mean, we obviously, after that first set, we can obviously see why this DuHawks team is ranked 15th nationally and why they are being recognized in the top 15. A lot of power from their outside hitters, and it just a lot of, they just have a lot of strength. They have a lot of depth on this team that makes them very successful. But all that starts with head coach Dylan Ross as well. You got to show the head coach a little love, and his assistants Patrick Hollander and Crystal Tranel. Crystal Tranel was a member from the women's volleyball team. If any of you had watched some of the women's volleyball games, you remember her, just a stud libero. And I know this men's volleyball team is very happy to have her as the defensive specialist on their coaching staff. Dylan Ross, on the other hand, the head coach, actually Loris grad from the class of 2018. He helped put this program together in 2014. And why not come back to coach the team that you helped start? Dylan Ross is the program all-time kills leader with 776 and the all-time points leader with 921. Very, very successful career for Dylan Ross. His name is mentioned in the record books quite a bit. Season, game, and career. You won't really go throughout that record book and not see Dylan Ross's name somewhere on those lists. But again, at this team, he has a lot of success in this team, and I think he's definitely a big reason for the 12-1 record for the DuHawks here. 10 seconds left on the clock, and the second set will get going. DuHawks will have service in the second set, and David Beach will be back to serve for the DuHawks. DuHawk bench starting the Let's Get Sexy chant for David Beach. His serve, Albers up to Dixon, and a double hit from the Regents. Point will go to the DuHawks. Beach still at service. Beach serve up and over. Dixon receives it. Albers to Padron. Padron's attempt received from Mayo. Siggenhorn's attempt just right and out of bounds. Kessel misplacement. Albers will go back to serve for the Regents for the first time in the second set. Mayo receives a serve. Beach up. Jake Filotto with the kill. And Filotto will go back to serve for the DuHawks. Jump serve received from Padron. Albers up to Dixon. Dixon's attempt Net violation, Duhawks, I believe, and point will go to the Regents. Dixon to serve again, dump serve. Oh, just long, out of bounds. Point Duhawks. Checking into the game for the Regents is number 19, Tristan Cox. And checking out is number 3, Isaiah Dixon. Back to serve for the Duhawks, Michael Dwar. Fox receive it. And just a little miscommunication there from the Regents. Albers looked to not, as if he didn't know exactly where that ball was up in the air, and just dropped down right next to him. Service into the net. Point goes to the Regents. We've seen a lot of those service errors here tonight between both teams. Yeah, both teams at 7 service errors apiece. Maya reserves the serve. Ziegenhorn's attempt. Dug by Albers. Padron up to McNear. Beats Mahoney. Oh, man. There was no stopping that kill from Pat Mahoney. I don't know how a lot of these guys can even go in front of the attempts from Mahoney. I think I'd move out of the way every time I see him leave the ground. McNear's attempt. Just long. Oh, but they are saying Duhawks tipped it and will give the point to the Regents. Substitution here. Coming into the game for the Regents will be number 14, Perez, in for McNear. Mayotte receives a serve. Oh, great hustle there. Mayotte's kill. Very powerful kill again from Mayotte. Another just excellent, excellent outside hitter. Only a freshman, so, I mean, we're going to be saying his name quite a bit in the future years on these live streams. Mayotte to serve. Received by Cox. Beach up to Filoto. Padron hug it. Up to Padron. His kill good. Good kill there from Padron. Jose Padron now up to 3 kills here in the match. Leading the team. Hess receives it. Beach up to Filoto. Filoto's attempt blocked. Right back onto the Duhawks side by Michael Moss. The drone back to serve. Filoto receives it. Beach up to Maya from the back row and into the net. Points will go to the Regents. The drone serve just long and out of bounds. Point will go to the Duhawks. Mahoney back at service for Loris. Jump serve. Drops down. Dixon receives it. Albers up to Dixon. Dixon's attempt. Duff for Mahoney. Filoto. Woo! Filoto with the powerful kill there. That's his second kill of the night. Jump serve from Mahoney. Albers up to Dixon. Dixon's attempt Mahoney's there. Beach up to Dwar. Dwar. Oh, they were saying it was tipped by Dixon. Point will go to the Duhawks after that Dwar kill. Mahoney serve. Drops down. Dixon receives it. Albers up to Moss. Moss. Padron into the net. Right there was David Beach and Michael Dwar. It's going to be a timeout by the Regents. Duhawks up 10-7 at the timeout. We have a minute 10 on the clock. Point into the timeout. A couple game leaders here leading the Duhawks in kills. We've got three people tied at four kills for the Duhawks. And as for Rockford, Jose Padron leading the team with three kills in this match. And right behind him is Isaiah Dixon and Connor McNear. If I'm the Regents, I'm going to want to look to get Padron and Dixon a little more action. Maybe even throw Connor McNear in there and get something going for them. Right now, Loris has a lot of momentum on their side, as the score shows, 10-7 in the second set. I mean, Loris is just playing a solid, solid match. And just by looking at the bench, I think Dorian Fienza's night is probably going to be over. He put back on his quarter zip. And I wouldn't be surprised if his night is over. Tends to play that first set against some teams, and then they save him for some others. So I wouldn't be surprised if we don't see Fienza the rest of the night. But three kills just for that one set. Very solid outing for Fienza in one set. Always a force to reckon with if you're the other team and you see Fienza on the court. Mahoney back to serve. His serve received by Magdaro. Moss up to Dixon. Dixon's attempt blocked. Stays on the region side. Dixon again. And out of bounds. Mahoney's still back at service for the Duhawks. Killer serve from Mahoney. Beach up to Filoto. Filoto's attempt. Oh, good hustle there from Albers. Moss has to get over. He does. Mahoney's there, though. Beach up to Dwar. Dwar's kill. Good. Kill for Michael Dwar. Duhawks look unstoppable right now. They have everything going for them currently. And Mahoney still back at service. Albers up to Moss. Belotto's there. Beach. Nice little tip. McNear read it. Padron gets it over. Mahoney. Beach sets up Dwar. Dwar's kill good. Dwar now up to six kills on the night. Up and over. Back to Dar receives it. Mayo. Beach. Filoto. Dixon's there. Albers to Padron from the back. Blocked by Dwar. 14-7 Duhawks. Mahoney still back to serve. Jump serve drops down. Mayo at Sarah Beach. Up to Filoto. Filoto. Beautiful kill there from Filoto. Just catching the line. Mahoney serve into the net. I didn't think that man was ever going to stop serving. I thought he was going to go the rest of the set. Kevin Kessel in for Mahoney after a very long stretch of serves from Mahoney. Moss will now serve for the Regents. Mayotte receives it. Beach up to Filoto. Filoto's kill. Oh, man. Right off the face of Connor McNear. What a kill from Jake Filoto. Beach back to serve for the Duhawks. They serve up and over. The drone gets it all over to Dixon. Dixon tips it. Kessel's there, though. I believe they're going to call a net violation on the Regents. It will be a point for the Duhawks. Duhawks now up 17-8 here in the second set. Dixon receives serve and just mishit that serve. Just hit off the arms wrong on the serve. Beach is given ace there. Padron receives a serve. Albers up to Dixon. Dixon's hit blocked by the Duhawks. Alders up to McNear, and McNear's attempt is in the net. Beach serve over in the net. Albers sets up Dixon. Dixon blocked by the Duhawks. Oh, good recovery there from Filoto. Kessel up to Ziegenhorn. Ziegenhorn attempt. Mayotte serve. Beach up to Filoto. Filoto's attempt tipped up in the air. Good hustle there from Dixon. The drone from the back row just out of bounds. Duhawks now up 28 in the late stages of the second set. David Beach still back at service. His serve just long. Josh Albers back to serve. Filoto receives a serve. Beach up to Mayo from the back row and good. Great kill there from Mayotte there. Filoto back to serve for the Duhawks. McDaro receives that serve. McNear's kill attempt blocked the net. Dixon just got to bump it over. Beach up to Ziegenhorn. Ziegenhorn right into the net. Block for McNear. Dixon to serve. Maya receives it. Beach up to Filoto from the back row. Dixon digs that one. Padron tip. Oh. Good spot there from Padron to make the Duhawks really have to throw their bodies around to try to get to it. Good spot from Dixon. After that, that kills from Padron. Dixon back to receive. And Dixon serve into the bottom of the net. Duhawks now up 22-11. Keegan Godwin back into the game along with Pat Mahoney. Godwin will now go back to serve for the Duhawks. Nagidar receives the serve from Godwin. McNear's kill attempt blocked, but the block goes out of bounds.
Point for Regents.
And it'll be a point for the Regents. each up for Ziegenhorn. Ziegenhorn's 10th, dug by Albers. Beach there. Kessel sets up Mayotte. Blocked, but Kessel's there. Beach to Mahoney, and huge kill there from Pat Mahoney. That's Mahoney's fifth for the night. Back to serve for the Duhawks. Freshman Ryan Floyd, and his serve just long. Point will go to the Regents. Duhawks up 23-13 in the second set. Perez checking back in for the Regents, and we'll go back to serve. Up for Padron, right back down onto the Regents. Blocked. Right there was Beach and Mahoney for the block. Mayotte back to serve. Aguilar receives it. Padron. Beach up for Filoto. Filoto's kill good. Good attempt. All right, and right as we go into the timeout at the end of the set, Duhawks win 25-13. And let's take a look at that kill one more time. Just absolutely filthy there from Filoto. Great set from David Beach, and that kill was just very nice. A lot of power on that one there. Duhawks up 2-0 over the Regents. Couple stat updates here for the Duhawks. They are up 26 kills to 10. And just a tough night for the Regents. Not really getting a lot going, but I'm looking over at their bench. You know, they're still having a great time. They're down 2-0, and I mean, they're just, they're dancing. They're dancing to the music. It's this team likes to have fun. You can tell. They don't care what their record says, what the score says. They're out here having fun, and that's all that matters. Duhawks on a solid roll here going into the third set. Duhawks are going to look to put it away after two great set wins. We've said Pat Mahoney's name quite a bit, and as I said earlier, the first All-American in program history. Mahoney is a senior this year. I know he probably has that fifth year eligibility, so we'll see if Mahoney decides to come back. If not, it would be an unfortunate loss for the Duhawks. Pat Mahoney, I mean, just a force to be reckoned with. Him and Fiorenza down in that front row, I mean, they are a lethal duo, those two together. But I know, I'm sure if Pat Mahoney doesn't come back, they will miss him quite a bit. But, you know, it's next man up, and I know for a fact Morris men's volleyball team will be they will have that backup ready, and we be like, we don't have Mahoney at all. . 35 seconds left on the clock. Third set begin here shortly. Buzzer sounds. Ref blows the whistle. Regents finish up their huddle. Duhawks out on the court. free. Figure out who has service. And it looks like Regents will take service for the start of the third set. Josh Albers back to serve. Albers with the jump serve.
Point Regents.
Attempt there from Clayton Nix. His attempt just long. Albers serve over Falota, receives it. Beach up to Dwar's attempt. Tipped at the net. Albers sets up Dixon. Dixon's attempt right off the chest of Nix. Dixon's been looking for that one all night. Just has not been able to get it until now. Maybe Regents up 2-0. Could we possibly see a set win for the Regents here? Who knows? Albers serve received from Falota. Beach up to Dwar. Dwar's hip, and he gets the kill. Almost missed that one there, but was able to adjust and tip it right over the net and find a spot. Falota to serve for the Duhawks. Violation by the Regents. Point will go to the Duhawks. Falota still back to serve. Falota serve. Ooh.
Point Regents.
Just out. From up here, that serve looked like it might have just caught the corner, but the line shuts. Saw differently. Falota to Beach. Beach Crushville. Oh, just stays in bounds. Checking into the game for the first time is senior number 7, Andres Martinez. Another great middle for the Duhawks. McNear. That's the net for Karpenko. Beach gets up. Krotoshville, and what a kill from him.
Incredible.
Albers up to Vargone. Padron attempt blocked at the net. Martinez with that block. Karpenko's attempt. Falota from the back row. Woo! Man, we've seen a lot of those back row kills from the Duhawks. It's working, it's working. Spar back to serve. To serve from. Nears attempt just long and out of bounds. Dwar back to serve. Alders up for McNear. McNear's attempt. Long and out of bounds. McNear wanted a tip, but the refs and line judges didn't see the tip. It would be point Duhawks. Dwar still back to serve. Up 8-3 are the Duhawks. Alders up to Karpenko. Close to the net. Oh.
Point Regents.
The point will go to Regis after that tip. Just found a spot that was a little tricky for the Duhawks to receive. Karpenko serve. Whew, Martinez. Whew. Man.
Point Duhawks.
Huge kill there from Martinez right in the middle. Ryan Floyd back to serve. Magdadaro receives it. Pedrone over. Filoto's there. Beach up to Filoto from the back row. Man! Filoto up to 7 kills on the night. Moss kill good. Just tipped and out of bounds by the Duhawks. Point will go to the Regents. Come back into the game. Number 14, Trey Perez, and he will go back to serve for the Regents. Point goes to the Duhawks there off the serve. Nick's at service for the Duhawks. Auber is up to Moss. Moss is blocked by Martinez. Whew.
Point Duhawks blocked, Martinez.
Any team's going to have a hard time trying to get one past Martinez right there in the middle. Martinez in at 6-4. Ooh. Serve just out of bounds. Fans here thinking it might have caught the line. Lines judge saw it differently from them. We're a little bit higher up, so we might have a different, definitely have a different angle at it. The drones at service. Filoto receives. Beach up to Nixon's back row and into the net. Service error on the Duhawks. Duhawks up 12-7 here in the third set. Beach Filoto. Filoto's dug by Magdadaro, but Filoto will get the point for the Duhawks. Coming into the game for the Duhawks, sophomore number 15, Zach Henstein. Blocked by the Duhawks. Pedrone gets it over. Henstein up to Beach. Beach to Filoto. Perez digs it. Beach to Nix from back row. Blocked. Oh, they're going to say over the net violation by the Duhawks. He had an attacker on Zach Heinstein. Moss to serve. Beach up to Dwar. Perez is there. Wow. Beach to Filoto. Filoto's kill just out of bounds. Unbelievable set there from David Beach to on the run, too. Beach on the run still manages to get that set up for Filoto in a good position to possibly have a chance at getting that kill. Moss serve just point left and out of bounds. Beach back to serve for the Duhawks once again. Jones receives a serve and out of bounds and off the scores table. David Beach will be rewarded with an ace.
Timeout, Regents.
Timeout called by the Regents. Duhawks up 15-9 going into the timeout. Could possibly be looking at a 3-0 sweep here tonight by the Duhawks. As I said, up 15-9. You know, they just Rockford just really hasn't had an answer for the Duhawks tonight. Duhawks able to find their spots on their kills. I mean, they're working as a team. They look good. Everything has been so fluid. And it just... And they are deserving of this win tonight. It's a team effort. Even the bench. You look at the bench. I've watched the bench all night. They're up big. They're about to sweep, but that bench is still in it. That bench is always having fun. You'll never look at that bench, and they're not having fun. Always starting chance as they're up for serving. Always into it, and that bench definitely a big part for this team's success as well. And as I speak, they're doing their chant for David Beach at service. The drone receives it at the net, and Falota's there to just tip it right back down on the region's side. Sees it. Oliver's up to Padron from the back, and kill there from Padron. Point will go to the Regents, 16-10. Oliver serve. Nick's there. Beach up to Filoto. Alders to Dixon, but Nix is there. Oh, good kill there from Karpenko. From off the dig of Nix, just up to the net. Karpenko is able to just put it right back down. Alders to serve. Beach up to Dwar, woo! Man! Just sent that thing right down to the court. I mean, there is no possibility of stopping that thing. Belotto back to serve. Mike Dara went to receive it, just hit it long. That would be a service ace from Jake Filoto. Filoto serve stays in. Oliver's up to Karpenko. Karpenko from the middle. His kill good. Point for the Regents. Dixon will now go back to serve. Dixon serve, received from Nix. Beach up to Dwar. Oliver's there for the dig. Magdadara to McNear. Block and tipped up in the air. Beach. Beach up to Dwar. Oh, man, again. My goodness. Huge kill from Dwar. Dwar's got 10 kills on the night. He's back to serve. Padron receives it. Oliver's up to Padron. Locked by the Duhawks. Michael Dwar back to serve again. Alders up to Karpenko. Karpenko attempt dug by the Duhawks. Nix kill. Oh, they're going to give the point to the Duhawks. They're saying Regents might have tipped it.
Point Duhawks.
Coach Samara going over to talk to the referee. Coach not too happy about that call. Duhawks up 21-12 here in the third set. Four serve receive from Cox. The drone attempt to Nix. Nix blocked by the Regents. Beach up to Crotterville. Throws there, McNear. Beats to Filoto from behind. Woo! Filoto from the back row. Another great kill from Filoto. Man. Door back to serve. Cox receives a serve. Mike Gagaro over to Padron. Padron's attempt. Wide right. Cox receive it. Alvers up to Padron. Padron, Nix is there. Beach up to Nix. Cox digs it. Martinez and Karpenko up the net. Karpenko wins that battle. He'll get the point for the Regents. Karpenko to serve. This serve just long and out of bounds. Duhawks now at 24. Game point for the Duhawks, and Ryan Floyd will be back to serve for what could possibly be the last point of the match. Oh, Beach tried to just tip it over, and he puts it right back on his own side. 24-14. McNear back to serve for the Regents. Filoto from the back row. He was going for the one there. Oh, McNear, just a miss hit. McDowell's got to get over him. He does. Impressive. Floyd up to Nix. And Nix is going to put it away for the Duhawks. 25-14 in the third set. Duhawks will take a 3-0 match victory over the Rockford University Regents. Very impressive game for the Duhawks. Great game from Jake Filoto. He came out big in the win. For the Rockford University Regents, they will be at home to take on Wabash College on Saturday. And as for the Loras College Duhawks, they will be at home as well, taking on Millikan University at 4 o'clock. Duhawks now move to 13-1 on the season. And as for the Rockford University Regents, they move to 2-14. Again, I'm Adam Rodriguez, and thanks for joining tonight. We will catch you next time for another Loras men's volleyball game.